students, I hope you all are well and fine. Once again, welcome back to your geography class. Today I am going to start with chapter number 8, Earthquakes of class 9. I have divided this chapter into three parts. In first part, we will discuss about the definition, characteristics and the causes of earthquake. Now, what is earthquake? Before starting this chapter, you need to know about this. By hearing this word, you can easily understand what is earthquake, right? Yes, it is a simple vibration. Okay, like this. It is a simple vibration. Now, there is a specific definition there in your book, which you can write in your exam. So, what is the specific definition? Like earthquake, it is a tremor. Okay, tremor means simple vibration. Below the earth's crust, that is, it is the surface of the earth, and below the earth crust, it's a tremor or vibration which will come and hit the earth surface. So this is basically earthquake. A tremor, first it will be in the interior part of the earth, and after that it will come and hit the earth surface or earth crust. I think most of us, we have experienced earthquake, right? But there are several examples present in our world book, that which is very much important also and which is very much destructive also. What are they? Like tsunami in the year of 2004. It caused huge or massive destruction of the property and the life of the people. In Assam, in 1986, severe earthquake have taken place. So these are the basic examples of earthquake. In NET, there are so many examples. You can search it from there also. So definition we have done. Now next is, what are the characteristics? Now what is the meaning of characteristics? You all know the basic features by which we can understand the nature of such object. Like this, earthquakes have so many characteristics. Number one, it is very sudden movement. Okay, suddenly it will take place. Then number two, why earthquake will take place? Because it is caused due to the movement of the plates. You have learnt about the plates in your chapter landform. So what are they? When the plates move, they come closer or they go away from each other, then also they cause earthquake. Number three point, it is like earthquake we cannot predict. Right? Suppose we cannot say that yes, this to this, in that particular phase earthquake will take place. We cannot say that. So it is very unpredictable. Number four, earthquake is measured by the means of scales. Scales means these are the some basic instruments by which we can measure the earthquakes. What are they? Mercalli scale is there. Then the Richter scale is there. One another instrument is there, that is seismograph. So these are the basic instruments by which we can measure the intensity of the earthquake. And last but not the least, earthquake is generally very destructive in nature. Obviously, there are some effects of earthquake which is positive also, but the basic effects of the earthquake is very massive destruction. Okay, so these are the general characteristics of the earthquakes. Now, next is, what are the causes? Causes means, what are the main reasons behind the earthquake? What are they? See, here I have written, number one, it is volcanic activity. Now, what is volcanic activity? In last chapter only, you have learnt about this. Volcanic activity means, below the earth surface, suppose this is the earth surface, below the earth surface, magma is present. Magma means hot and molten material. Due to the huge pressure and temperature, when this magma will come outside of the earth crust, it is known as volcanic activity or volcanic eruption. So here see, below the earth surface, okay, hot and molten magma, along with this, hot gases are also present. Okay, The temperature and pressure, both of them, they are just pushing the heat up. So heat is pushed up vertically. When heat is coming up vertically, what will happen? Heat will come up and like this, it will hit the crust, earth's crust. And then vibration will take place over the earth crust. So this is the basic reason of earthquake. So again, I am describing this. So we know that below the earth's surface, there is immense amount of heat present. Okay, and due to pressure and temperature, the heat is pushed upwards. When the heat will come upwards, automatically it will hit our surface of the earth like this. And that's what it will cause huge vibration on the crust. Okay, so this process is known as volcanic eruption. That's why it is told that volcanic activity or volcanic eruption is related to earthquake. Generally, volcanic activity follows earthquake and vice versa. Earthquake also follows the volcanic activity. I want to state one example, like in Krakatoa Island, which is there in West Indies. What happened there? Volcanoes of Krakatoa Island, it is caused due to the severe earthquake. So see here, you can just interrelate between earthquake and volcanic activity. So this is the number one reason or cause. Number two is plate tectonic. It is the most important cause for the earthquake. What is that? See here, I have drawn the plates. Plates means, you know, simple, the pieces of the rocks. Okay. So when two plates will come close to each other, then obviously they are moving, and due to their movement, vibration will take place. Number one. Number two, when the two plates will move far away from each other, then what will happen? Again, movement is taking place and it is causing the tension force. By this also, earth crust can be vibrated. Done. And then next point is, see, it is the transverse. Transverse, or you can say that it is transform plate boundary. What is that? Like one plate is there, another plate is there, and they will just slide away from each other. Now you can do one thing. Please rub your hand. When we are rubbing our hand, what is going on? We can see that heat is generated. No, your hands will be warm up. So like this, when two plates will slide away to each other, then what will happen? Heat will be taken place, or heat will be formed. Okay. So though they are striking, that's why they will form the heat. And due to that heat, again here one vibration will take place. Because previously no heat was there. That means it was the normal condition. Again, if due to the striking of these two plates, when heat will be generated, obviously this heat will create a certain amount of vibration. And this vibration is nothing but the earthquake. So these are the basic three forms of the plate tectonic movements. You all know. Now, next point, like number three point that I am going to discuss, it is the faulting and folding. Okay, what is that? Number C is folding and faulting. Okay, folding means obviously when two plates are coming close to each other, obviously the center part will be uplifted. Suppose here one plate, here another plate. Sediments were present. When they are coming closer, that means they are giving pressure inside this or in this sediments. Obviously, after few years, this sediment will rise up. So it is causing the fold. Like this, fold mountains have been formed. Okay. So this is the folding. And what is faulting? Faulting means nothing but the general cracks on the crust of the earth. Okay. So the internal compression and tension forces are generally caused by this are generally caused by the plate tectonic and so on. Okay, so when this folding and faulting is taken place, what is going on? Obviously, due to the folding and faulting, the plates are again here moving towards and apart from each other. Like this, this also causes the earthquake. So folding and faulting, it also plays an important role over here. Done. And please remember one thing, folding means two plates will come close to each other. Faulting means two plates will go away from each other. Done. Now, last but not the least, number D point is man-made activity. Man-made activity. What is that? That means not only the nature, the human beings are also responsible for causing of earthquake. Now what happened? Due to the technical development and scientific development, people, they generally now become superior. We all know. What they do? They construct the dams. They are creating the roads in hilly regions. Due to the nuclear explosion, due to the blasting of rocks, when this phenomena will be taken place near any weak region. Weak region means if the region is seismically active, that means rocks are not so tightly impacted. Okay, so due to these activities, obviously vibration will take place, and like this, it will cause the huge and massive destruction of the land surface, that means earthquake. Like I'm going to give you one example, like in Koyna river, like Maharashtra Koyna, in the year of 1906, this region experienced huge amount of and huge intensity of earthquake. Why so? Because people, they just developed, or they developed one big dam on this Koyna river. And dam means what? Dam means one construction will take place and it will give the pressure on the land. If the land is not so strong, if it is weak in nature, then what will happen? The land will collapse. Okay, so these are the basic causes of the earthquake. Number one, I discussed the volcanic activity. Number two, it is the collision of the plates or plate tectonics. Number three, that is folding and faulting, because the folding and faulting, it is also caused by the movement. When the movement will take place beneath the earth's surface, obviously, it will be one of the major causes of earthquake. And last but not the least, that is man-made activity. Like nowadays, people are also getting engaged in the creation of earthquake. So today we will not proceed too much. And in our next video, like in part 2, I'll describe about the several terminology that is related to earthquake and the anatomy of the earthquake. Till then, thank you and take care.